The web grows ever more complex, with websites now larger and doing more complicated things than ever before. Meanwhile, it's being accessed by users on many different device types under many different network conditions. There's the latest, greatest desktop and mobile devices, budget and legacy devices, and the devices where web usage is on the rise. The sheer variety of different ways to access the web means websites with performance optimizations are going to offer very different user experiences to those without. For example, here's an iPhone 8 on a 4G connection loading CNN.com. It takes 4.5 seconds for the content to begin rendering, with 13 seconds passing in total before everything is fully loaded. It's not amazing, but it's usable. Now here's the same website loading on a less powerful Moto G4 on a 3G connection. Here, the user is stuck looking at the white screen for a huge 12.5 seconds, with 51 seconds passing total before everything has finished loading. By the time the iPhone 8 user on the right is able to engage and interact with the website, the Moto G4 user is still staring at the white screen. When you see them side by side like this, it really puts a huge difference in loading experience in perspective, doesn't it? And devices like the Moto G4 are more common than you think. Check this out, for instance, the Amazon.co.uk mobile bestsellers list. There's lots of sub-£200 smartphones here which have full internet capability but not a lot of oomph. If a website is poorly optimized, these budget devices will struggle with loading performance, leading to a slow, unresponsive, inaccessible website which will just result in a frustrating user experience. On a blog, users need to read posts. On a government website, users need to access important information and services. On an e-commerce website, users need to browse and buy things. If a user isn't able to engage with a website and interact with what's been built, rather than being patient and just waiting, it's more likely if nothing seems to be happening or if things aren't working as expected, they'll just abandon the website and go elsewhere. In 2011, 1&1 Internet ran a survey around people's experiences with slow websites. The results were pretty interesting. 50% of people surveyed believe websites either remain the same speed or are now even slower than in the web's earlier days. 71% feel their browsing is regularly disrupted by slow websites. 78% feel negatively towards a slow or unresponsive website. 44% believe a slow online transaction makes them doubt that it was successful. And 42% of men and 35% of women decided not to use a website again because it was slow. Google discovered that on 70% of the mobile landing pages they analysed, it took more than 5 seconds for the visual content in just the viewport to load, whilst it took more than 7 seconds to fully load all content. They estimate that as page load times go from 1 second to 10 seconds, the probability of a mobile site visitor leaving immediately, aka bouncing, increases by 123%. Also, the BBC found that for every second it takes for their website to load, they lose an additional 10% of users. Given that, according to Google, more than half of users abandon the visit if a mobile site takes over 3 seconds to load, it's little wonder that lots of websites are losing lots of users because of the lack of consideration for performance. This is a huge missed opportunity. If we don't accommodate users by optimising our websites for a variety of different device types and network conditions, it's unlikely they'll stay on the website, and even less likely they'll become customers.